Good morning, children. Hope you are all fine. So, in this session, we are going to discuss about two things. What are they? The first one, the great minds of chemistry, and followed by applications of chemistry. Right? First, we can move to the great minds of chemistry. It's all about scientists, famous scientists, and about their inventions and discoveries. Right? So look at the chart. So first one, Henry Cavendish. He was a British scientist and philosopher. Okay, he was a British scientist and philosopher. He is noted for his discovery of hydrogen. Right? So Henry Cavendish discovered hydrogen. Second one, Joseph Priestley. He was an English chemist and philosopher. Okay, Joseph Priestley was an English chemist and philosopher. He discovered 10 gases including oxygen, carbon monoxide and sulfur dioxide. Right? Next we can move to the third one, Lavoisier. He recognized and named hydrogen and oxygen. Okay? He developed the law of conservation of mass. Next, John Dalton. He was an English chemist and metallurgist. He proposed the atomic theory. Okay, so John Dalton proposed the atomic theory. Next one, Mendeleev. He was a Russian chemist. Okay, Mendeleev was a Russian chemist. And he formulated the periodic table of elements, right? Mendeleev formulated the periodic table of elements. Next, Marie Curie. Marie Curie is most famous for the discovery of the elements radium and polonium, right? Next one, J.J. Thomson. He was a British physicist, okay? He is credited for the discovery of electron. Okay, he discovered, that's J.J. Thomson discovered electron. Next one, P.C. Rai. He is one of the famous Indian scientists. Okay, founder of India's first pharmaceutical company. He is regarded as the father of Indian chemicals. Here I used the word pharmaceutical now. Pharmaceutical means it actually relates to the, related to the medicinal drugs. Okay. So next one, Rutherford. He is regarded as the father of, Rutherford is regarded as the father of nuclear physics. Okay. And he discovered the nucleus of an atom. Right. Next one, S.N. Bose. He was an Indian mathematician and physicist. Okay. He is best known for his work on quantum mechanics and also the theory of Bose-Einstein condensate, right? Next one, C.N.R. Rao. He is an Indian chemist who has worked mainly in solid state and structural chemistry, right? The last one, Venkatraman Ramakrishnan. He is an Indian biologist. He studied the structure of ribosomes, right? Once again, I'll tell you children, just listen. First one, Henry Cavendish, okay? He came to be known as, Henry Cavendish discovered hydrogen, okay? Henry Cavendish discovered hydrogen. Actually, he belongs to and he was a British scientist and philosopher. Next, Joseph Priestley discovered 10 gases, including oxygen, sulfur dioxide and carbon monoxide. In Lavoisier, he developed the law of conservation of mass. John Dalton proposed the atomic theory. Mendeleev formulated the periodic table of elements. Otherwise, he designed the periodic table of elements. Both are same only. Marie Curie discovered the element radium, elements radium and polonium. J.J. Thomson discovered electrons. P.C. Rai, he is an Indian, famous Indian scientist, founder of India's first pharmaceutical company, and he is regarded as the father of Indian right. X. Rutherford is regarded as the father of nuclear physics. He discovered the nucleus of an atom. S. N. Bose, he is best known for his work on quantum mechanics and also theory of Bose-Einstein condensate. And C. N. Rao has worked mainly in solid state and structural chemistry, right? The last one, Venkatraman Ramakrishnan, is an Indian biologist and he studied the structure of ribosomes. Okay, so these are the famous scientists as well as their inventions and discoveries. Okay, that's the things about the great minds of chemistry. Next, we can move to the applications of chemistry. Okay, chemistry plays a very important and useful role. Okay, towards the growth and development of various types of industries, various kinds of industries such as cement industry, textile industry, dyes industry, plastic industries, etc. Now we can see the applications of chemistry in various fields. First we can move to the agriculture. Okay, to improve the crop production, scientists have developed many chemicals such as fertilizers, pesticides, insecticides and fungicides. Fertilizers are chemicals that are used to provide nutrients to the crops to increase the crop production. Okay, here the word nutrients, it is nothing but it actually a substance which provides energy for their growth, that is called the nutrient. Okay, next, insecticides and pesticides are chemicals that are used to kill the insects and pests. These insects and pests, it totally affects the production of crops, right? Next, fungicides. Fungicides are chemicals only. It is mainly used to destroy the fungus. Okay. Next one, clothing. Clothes are made from fibers. Then what is meant by fiber? A fiber is a thin thread of natural or artificial substance that are used to make clothes and then rope, etc. Okay, fibers can be classified into two. What are they? One is the natural fiber and another one is the artificial fiber. What's the difference between natural fiber and artificial fiber? So now fibers can be classified into natural fibers and artificial fibers. Okay, if you take the natural fibers, fibers which are obtained from plants and animals are called the natural fibers. Okay, so fibers which are obtained from plants and animals are called the natural fibers. What are the examples we can give for natural fibers? Cotton, silk, wool, jute. These are some of the examples of natural fibers. Then what about artificial fibers? Artificial fibers are prepared from chemical substances. Okay, you got it everyone? Artificial fibers are prepared from chemical substances. For example, nylon, rayon, polyester, terephthalate. These are some of the examples of what? Artificial fiber. Okay, now you understand the meaning for natural fiber and artificial fiber, children. Natural fibers means obtained from plants and animals. Okay, and artificial fibers means obtained from chemical substances. That's the difference between natural fiber and artificial fiber. You got it, everyone? Shall we move to the next one? Third one, food. Food additives are made by chemicals only. Okay, so these additives are included in the food to improve their shelf life, appearance as well as flavor. Here shelf life means it is nothing but specific period of time. And of course you know very well, flavor means it is nothing but taste of food. Okay, preservatives such as sodium benzoate and sodium metabisulfate are used for the preservation of food. Then what is the meaning for preservation? Preservative means it is nothing but a substance which prevents from food spoiling organism. Okay, that is called the preservative. Artificial sweeteners such as saccharin, aspartame are used food. Artificial sweetener means it is nothing but sugar substitute. Okay. And for cooking purpose, we use refined oils, isn't it? So these refined oils are made by chemical processes only. Okay. Some of the food items such as jams, jellies, milk, tea, these food items are preserved by chemical processes to increase that shelf life. Understood everyone? Can you understand what I am saying? Okay, next we can move to the building materials. Building materials such as cement, mortar, bricks, steel, glass and then varnishes are used for the construction of roads, buildings, house, etc. Okay. So these building materials are prepared from chemical, manufactured from chemical processes only. Okay. Here I told you no varnish. Varnish is nothing but a liquid coating material, right? And mortar, it is a mixture of cement, sand and water. Okay. So these building materials are manufactured through chemical processes only, right? Next we can move to useful materials. Some of the useful materials such as synthetic rubber, synthetic dyes, synthetic fibers and plastics have been developed and used in various industries, right? Next one we can move to the medicines. Medicines are chemical substances that are used for the prevention and treatment of diseases, right? Some of the medicines like paracetamol, aspirin, penicillin, tetracycline, amphicillin are used for the treatment of various health problems, right? And some medicines, some chemicals have used to eradicate polio and eradicate smallpox. What is the meaning for eradicate? To destroy completely. Okay. Both polio and smallpox are viral infections. Right. Next we can move to metals and alloys. Metals are extracted from their ores by chemical processes only. Okay. So the alloys of metals find application in many products such as machines, automobiles, etc. Got it? Right. Next we can move to cosmetics and other consumer products. Generally, we use cosmetics for beautifying the appearance and also for cleansing purpose, isn't it? So some of the cosmetics like talcum powder and then lotions, creams, lipsticks, eyeshadows and then perfumes, hair styling gels, everything are made by chemicals only. Okay. So, some of the talcum powder is mainly prepared from a mineral called talc. Okay. Many things that we are using in our day-to-day life such as soaps, detergents, pen, ink and then plastics, everything are made by chemical processes only, right? Finally, we can move to the electronics. Chemistry has helped in metalloids. Chemistry has helped in finding the property of electrical conductivity of metalloids such as silicon and germanium. Electrical conductivity means it is nothing but it conducts the electricity. And what is meant by metalloids? Metalloids means elements which exhibit both the metallic property as well as non-metallic property are called the metalloids. Okay. So this special property makes the silicon and germanium, which is helpful in the electronics industry. Okay. For the manufacture of many electrical circuits which is used in radios, televisions, computer chips and solar cells, etc. Okay, so these are the things about the electronics. So these are some of the applications of chemistry that we are used in our usage. Okay, it's mainly everything it is based on chemistry only. Okay, everything, all the things, if you take even from agriculture, clothing, food, building materials, everything is made by chemical products. processes only. That point you should remember. Okay. Now I will give you the home assignment, children. The first one we discussed about the great minds of chemistry. No. So everything, nearly 12 scientists, I have mentioned about 12 scientists, about their inventions and discoveries, isn't it? Everything you have to go through, everything you should read, and also the applications of chemistry in various fields like agriculture, clothing, food, building materials, useful materials, medicines, metals and alloys, cosmetics and other consumer products, and finally electronics. Everything you should read. But your writing work is, you have to write the great minds of chemistry one time in your rough note. This is your home assignment. Okay. So try to complete your assignment, children. Thank you.